Google just released a bunch of new details about how to keep your Google Merchant Center from being suspended. Hey, this is John Horn from Stub Group. We're the number one resource for fixing Google suspensions and policy violations, and we're also one of the top premier Google partner digital advertising agencies in the world. So let's talk about this new information from Google. They released this article called Building Trust with Your Customers, and it's related to Google's misrepresentation policy. So if you haven't had to deal with a suspension in Google Merchant Center, awesome, hope you never have to deal with it. But if you do, there's a good chance you're going to see that word misrepresentation. So let's dig into these new details that Google has released. Some of these are new, some of them are reiterations of things that they've talked about in the past, or reiterations of things that we already knew about here at Stub Group because we do so much work with clients who hire us to get them unsuspended, but they might be things that Google hasn't necessarily released in as much detail previously. So let's go through this. First of all, Google is saying that your business identity online is very important when they're looking to see whether or not they want to allow you to run Google Shopping ads through Google Merchant Center. And here's something that's really a little bit new or different. So Google is saying sometimes it can take some time before a sufficient level of trust is established and before we consider it safe to display your offers to customers. In other words, they are saying, hey, we might suspend you now, but maybe we'll reconsider things later on once you have built up more reputation online, maybe have more reviews, more domain history, something like that. Now, a lot of businesses need Google to actually drive the business to their website that then allows them to create those reviews and create that history. So obviously, it's still important that you get unsuspended if you are dealing with a suspension. And I wouldn't say I'll just wait around on Google and maybe they'll smile upon you sometime in the future. There's probably things we can do to help you out right now. So when Google says business identity, they're talking about the official business name that you use on the web and avoiding mismatches between that business name, your domain name, the information you have in your Google Merchant Center account, and so forth. Basically, the name that you use online is very important. And there are a bunch of different places that Google looks at on your website and accounts to see what you're using. And so that's one of the aspects of our very detailed audits that we do when businesses hire Stub Group to get them unsuspended is looking and making sure that the business name shows up in the way that Google wants it to show up. I include an About Us page. That's the next bullet point in Google's new article here. And that's also something that we found to be very important. Basically, you're trying to establish credibility with Google and make sure that they and people who are browsing your website know who you are and what your business model is. Also, let customers know that they can follow you on social media profiles and link to those pages from your website. That's a good tip. Again, it's about building up your reputation online. Transparency. Google says to be clear and provide detailed information about your policies, including shipping, returns, and privacy policies. There are some very specific policies that Google wants to see on your website, and we have detailed templates that we help our clients with to make sure that they're saying exactly what Google wants them to say and providing all the necessary information in the way that Google wants to see it, because this is something that's very important to Google. Google also says, kind of common sense, be transparent about your business model and how you operate. So if you've got fees that you're trying to tack on or weird things that you're doing, be transparent. If you do have membership fees or things like that, there are ways that you can correctly communicate that on your product pages and your policies and your checkout process. And that's something that we can help you think through. Then Google talks about your online reputation. So help potential customers understand how to use your products or how other customers have used them. Show reviews and testimonials about your products and business. Again, pretty straightforward and also, again, hard to accomplish if you're a new business just starting out because you haven't had the opportunity to create those reviews. There are still ways that we can get you unsuspended. You don't have to have reviews. It's just something that is helpful as part of the big picture as Google looks at your business and credibility. If you've received any badges or seals of approval from official third-party sources, make sure that you mention these. So for example, things like a Better Business Bureau accreditation, any other types of award seals, things that you've earned from third-party sources, Google is saying that it can be helpful to feature those on your website as credibility elements. Then you have clearly communicate how customers can interact with you by making sure that they know how to get in touch with you and how your customer support is set up. They're talking about contact methods. This is very important, making sure that people can reach out to you through your website. And there are some specific things that Google likes to look for and see when it comes to your contact information. Google also says if you publish a blog post or if your business was mentioned in an article, make sure your customers know about this. Basically, again, if there's credibility out there online, try and reference that on your website. And then professional design, Google says to install an SSL certificate so customers know that their sensitive data is retrieved and stored securely without being intercepted by hackers. Pretty straightforward. Make sure you're using HTTPS on your website and that it is up to date. Also, your website should be accessible for all customers, easy to navigate, and shouldn't contain any unnecessary redirects or redirects to broken links. This is also something that we look for in our detailed audits, trying to find problems. Very often when clients come to us, we find a bunch of broken links or issues with their website that they just weren't aware existed, and that can contribute to just not a professional experience or look that can contribute to misrepresentation suspensions. Also, Google says avoid placeholders for text and images. Pretty straightforward. You know, don't say coming soon, things like that. Just don't release things live until they're ready to go live. And then Google also has some information about how you can help them learn more about your business. So making sure that you're providing accurate and relevant information in Google Merchant Center, linking relevant third-party programs to Google Merchant Center, if you have seller ratings, leveraging those, and making sure that the product data you send to Google is accurate and matches your website, things like that. Again, these are all things that are part of the detailed audits that we do of customer websites and Google Merchant Centers and Google Ads accounts when we are helping them face either misrepresentation suspensions or any other type of suspension as well, because these are all factors that Google is looking at when they decide whether to suspend you and whether to reactivate your account.
Hey, thanks for watching another Knowledge Pack video from Stub Group. We're the number one resource for fixing Google suspensions and policy violations. We're also one of the top premier Google partner agencies in the world. We'd love to help you fix your suspension, dominate Google Ads, and grow your business. So please subscribe to this channel for more great tips and insights into all things Google. And check out the description below to get expert help for your own suspension. Thanks.